Nhlanhla Bhengu, daughter of teacher and artist Gerard Bhengu. He had one daughter from his first marriage, and she was very dear to him. Today, she is visiting his father's resting place. Bhengu was 80 years old when he died in the township of Umlazi outside Durban. He did not live long enough to get a chance to see his work being honored. This former Church of St. Cow missionary has been rebuilt into a museum dedicated only to Gerard Bhengu's work.
I used to ask him where he studied to draw, since he could draw so well and portray people the way they were. And he would say he did not study anywhere. It was his God-given talent. I was so fascinated. I would stand next to him and watch him paint.
Nontlanhla is here for the official opening. She says she was always fascinated by his father's work. As a young man, Bhengu used to sell his paintings at Durban Station to commuters. It was only later that his work caught the eye of Dr. Max Conley in the St. Cow Mission Hospital. He paid for his treatment with his artworks. Conley introduced him to works by the older masters, and his formal art training included making copies of these. In his spare time, Conley was doing research on the local Nguni language tribes, such as Baita, found in the southern KwaZulu-Natal. Bhengu started working with Conley as an illustrator for records on the difference and similarities found amongst these people.
Because Bhengu is a sad story when you think of it. He was born in 1910, and those of us that know the history know that that's when the Union of South Africa was created. And he died in 1990, in the same month that Nelson Mandela was freed. So that spans a very sad part of South Africa's history, especially for people like Bhengu. So it's a great credit to his endeavor that he persevered to the point where he was able to preserve such a collection of art.
The KwaZulu-Natal Department of Arts and Culture says Bhengu is one of the many late artists that they want to credit and honor.
This is part of that program of preserving our own heritage as a province of KwaZulu-Natal. There are a number of our artists who died poor, unfortunately, that we want to reclaim and restore their dignity through this project. But over and above preserving what is already there, we have a plan in the province of building or establishing an arts academy so that our artists can start learning art skills from secondary level, but also have a place where they can go and get further skills for them to be able to perform and participate in international platforms like any other artist.
With this museum, local government here hopes to revive tourism in the area and boost economic development.
The project is not the intention of building an art gallery and museum, although that was a very fine objective. We're really trying to develop the economy to create a tourism destination. And our tourism product that we're trying to promote is called mission tourism. And what happens is mostly when people think of mission tourism, they think of religious tourism. Whereas really mission tourism is about architecture, art, human endeavor, history. And so the opportunity of creating an art gallery to the memory of Gerard Bhengu added to the product of mission tourism.
Plans for Bhengu to study art at the Natal Technical College in Durban were rejected because of the strict apartheid laws then, which denied formal art training for black artists. Nevertheless, Bhengu's work went on to be exhibited in major art galleries around the country. In his later life, he was a teacher of art in schools around Umlazi. Sibuhlela for Morning Live in St. Cow, outside Bulawayo.